hauled in from the freezing waters by a nearby vessel. They escaped almost certain death. But many are not this lucky. The seafloor and shoreline are littered with the rusting hulls of 100 fishing boats and with the bones of 1,000 fishermen. Crab fishing on the Bering Sea is extremely dangerous. From year to year, the grim toll rarely changes. One fisherman will die almost every week during the two-month season. This is considered by many to be the deadliest job in the world. The adventure begins in a small town in the middle of the Aleutians. A string of bleak volcanic islands that stretch over 1,000 miles into the Bering Sea. This is the busiest commercial fishing port in the United States, Dutch Harbor. The town was founded by Russian seal traders in 1768. Their Orthodox church still stands as a beacon for souls lost at sea. In the 1940s and 50s, a market developed for the giant Alaskan king crab, and Dutch Harbor became a center of the crab fishing industry. The world's appetite for king crabs soon outstripped the supply, and the smaller Opelio crab, commonly called snow crab, filled the void. Today, most of Dutch Harbor's 4,000 inhabitants work in the shipyards or processing plants. But the town is also a magnet for adventurers who come from around the globe to risk their lives for a piece of the billion-dollar payoff.
And the money is a good payday, you know? There ain't nothing like it. It's a gamble. You gotta admit it's a gamble, but I like taking this gamble. It's one I choose to accept.
I work half the year. I make more than most people make in a couple of years in half the year.
But for some, the costs outweigh the rewards.
This year, cracked 2 ribs. Don't know the extent of the damage to my knee yet. My boat blew up. I burned my hair off. Well, I got my hand tore off halfway. All my skin was off my knuckles. Bear claw, lion claw, and my claw. Other than that, it's been a great year.
This is a different breed of men who make a pact with and accept the consequences of a cruel sea. Crab fishing is a gamble from start to finish, and the betting begins at a warehouse in Dutch Harbor.
This will be a closed meeting for members only.
Captains of all the fishing boats are locked in negotiations with the processing plants over this year's price of crab. Yesterday, processors made a bid of 84 cents a pound. It was rejected. Although the season opened yesterday, not one of the 250 crab boats will go out until a price is settled. Rick Mezich is captain and owner of the Fierce Allegiance.
Hopefully, you know, get a better price of 85, 86, 87, and, you know, wait and see if we can get it.
A few pennies can make a big difference when the quota is set at 186 million pounds of crab. An offer has just been phoned in, 90 cents a pound. The skippers almost unanimously accept. The crab fishermen's gamble paid off. They got a $12 million raise. At 187 feet, the Fierce Allegiance is one of the largest boats in the fleet. In the days leading up to the season, Rick Mezich and his crew have worked around the clock to prepare the boat. Tony La Russa has been the deck boss of the Fierce Allegiance for many years. He knows all too well the dangers that lie ahead.
The weather could change on us. It's out here, it changes every second. 1 hour it could be flat calm, the next hour it can be blowing 40, 60, even 80 miles an hour. If you work 30-foot seas, that could be hitting you broadside. And with 250 pots on board, or even 200 for the smaller boats that are out there, it's a very dangerous situation that you get into. Because on the way out, we could be hitting weather, we could be hitting ice, and this whole stack could be a complete ice cube by the time we get out there.
Ice collects on the mountain of pots on the deck. A top-heavy boat can easily flip and sink. The chief engineer, Eric Whitaker, is responsible for keeping the powerful diesel engines running at all times. Also on board the vessel are three fishermen who have braved this treacherous season before. Danny Saria, his brother Johnny Saria, and Tim Probst have paid their dues. They are the full share guys. Signing on for this trip are two first-timers, commonly called greenhorns. Joe Johnson is only 19 years old.
My favorite part about fishing is probably the work, man. It's about, and the money. Yep, that's about it.
Nathan Ellington is 21.
My job basically is just to do whatever I'm told and try to do it as fast as possible.
This is the crew of the Fierce Allegiance. Together, they will tempt fate for a share of the riches.
I've been crab fishing for 10 years. And those 10 years, I've probably heard 14 maydays and know of five friends that have gone down and died in the Bering Sea.
Saving lives is the job of the Coast Guard cutter Morgenthau. When you're hundreds of miles at sea with a crushed skull, a Coast Guard helicopter is your only hope to reach a hospital in time. In the coming weeks, Petty Officer Todd McKenna and his crew will see plenty of action.
We're basically here to respond to any emergency that might arise. Generally, during crab openers, there's a lot of medevacs, smashed hands, closed head injuries, concussions, pinched limbs.
Also on board the Fierce Allegiance is Lance Nylander, owner of Seattle's Dungeness Crab Works. He plans to test some new inventions under the harsh conditions of real crabbing.
My job is to build the best aquatic traps in the world. The way I see it, that is my goal.
With all 250 pots mended and prepped, it's time for the crew of the Fierce Allegiance to stack them on deck and prepare to head to sea. First light, the Fierce Allegiance sets course for the fishing grounds. 180 miles northwest in the middle of the Bering Sea. Their goal will be to fill the storage tanks as quickly as possible, haul the catch back to Dutch Harbor, restock, and rush out again.
Tim! Tim! Go for that hook!
The men will work day and night, rotating shifts of 18 hours on and 6 hours off. The bitterly cold and relatively shallow waters of the Bering Sea contain the most productive and most dangerous fishing grounds anywhere on Earth. With bad weather on the way, the crew of the Fierce Allegiance will earn their keep.
This program is brought to you in part by American Airlines, giving you more room throughout coach.
This is your captain speaking. If I could have your attention for a moment, folks, I'd just like to say that American is proud to be the only airline to remove seats throughout coach, so you all can have more room to cross your legs. However, we do kindly request that you not all do it at the same time. Thank you.
No one knows what the future of technology will bring, but we do know Corning will help bring it to you. On a road of pure light, the global optical network, and at its center, Corning, discovering beyond imagination.
Guests love getting free local calls, voicemail, and a data port in each La Quinta room, and $10 cash when they check out. Look for this coupon in USA Today or at LaQuinta.com. And call La Quinta. You stay, we pay.
So, Brian, you save us money on those office supplies?
Yes, sir. I went to Staples. They have unbeatable prices.
Oh.
That's because they have a price guarantee.
A price guarantee? Impressive.
I thought so too, sir.
I like your thinking.
Really?
You betcha. You're going to go far, Brian. What are you people doing standing around? Get back to work.
Staples has guaranteed low prices in-store, catalog, or online.
Oh, Becky, look.
Wow.
There's the Big Dipper. And there's Orion.
Daddy?
Uh-huh?
Who turns off the stars at night?
Nobody. They're on all night.
So how can we never see them from home?
Discover the world through a new set of eyes. Go RVing. Visit an RV dealer or call for a free video.
The latest science, new discoveries. A lost world comes back to life.
Less than 1% of that block has been looked at, and we're finding things about the plants, the microfauna, about the animal itself. We're getting a more complete picture than just if we brought the bones back. 99% of that block is still waiting to be opened.
Enter the land of the mammoth. Tonight at 8 Eastern and Pacific on the Discovery Channel. Continue the Discovery experience. Go to discovery.com.
Out with the old, in with the new. GCI Cable is going digital, and to make the upgrade even easier, there will be two big days of fun at GCI. Digital Days at GCI, March 9th and 10th, is your chance to win great prizes like a color TV, digital telescope, and lots more. There will be treats for the kids and refreshments for all. Meet Sharky from the Discovery Channel, and don't forget to bring in your old CFT 2200 converter box. It's easy, fun, and you'll be digital ready. Digital Days at GCI, March 9th and 10th.
The ancients called diamonds splinters of stars. To others, they were tears of the gods. The Greeks believed the fire of a diamond reflected the unquenchable flame of love. Through the ages, nothing has captured the fire of man's passion like the fire of a diamond, the ultimate symbol of love. Only a diamond is forever.
When you've got something special to say, let Carl's Jewelers help you say it.
Crab season starts in mid-January and lasts about 8 weeks. In calm weather, the Fierce Allegiance might be able to fill its 300,000-pound storage tanks in less than a week. The crew's goals are simple. 4 trips, 1 million pounds of crab, and no serious injuries.
Full share is 4% on the vessel. The two greenhorns are on the vessel right now. Start at 1%, and I promise another half for them if they do a good job and work out.
A full share crew member could earn up to $50,000 for just 2 months' work. That's the lure that draws them to risk almost everything.
Right off that 12 feet at a time.
The greenhorns are introduced to the grinder, a nasty, growling machine that chops up blocks of frozen herring for bait. Over the next 8 weeks, these young men will spend hundreds of hours feeding this machine, churning out a constant flow of chum for the crab pots.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 15.
A machine that grinds bait can also grind fingers.
Nathan. Never open that up with just running and stick your hand in there. You never need to open that up. Just stop, and then you can open it up, stick your hand, and just open that up, put your hand in there with the thing running.
A few test pots have been launched and pulled back.
This is an Opie stick, 4 inches. You always measure that Opie from the widest part, from back to back. Stick touches, it's legal. That'd be legal. This is a non-legal crab, as you can see. Nothing under this stick. Illegal. All right?
The small crabs are thrown back into the ocean.
$136.
6, 136 has the plastic tunnels of lances.
Below deck, Lance Nylander prepares his latest inventions.
And a bait sack with feathers off it, I guess you could call them. Pot lures, flasher, and it'll run for 30 hours. Some hoochies, low hoochies.
Lance affectionately calls one of his brainchildren the disco light.
Yeah, we'll just drop it in the pot just to see if it'll help attract the fish. I don't know if this will handle the depth, but hopefully if it fills up with water, it'll still run, it'll just quit flashing. Put good on a Christmas tree. But hey, you never know. Nothing venture, nothing gain. So we'll give it a shot and see what happens.
With temperatures dropping into the teens and snow falling, Tony gives his final lecture on how to survive the job.
Okay, first things first. Safety's number one, you guys. Nobody gets hurt. If everybody comes home without an injury, we've had a good season. We make money, we had a great season. We had fun, we had a dream season. Whenever you hear that beeper whatsoever, I want you to look physically at your feet. Make sure there's no line wrapped around your feet.
On the bottom of the pot.
A beeper signals for the launch of the pot. As the pot plunges to sea bottom, 600 feet of rope will uncoil on deck. One misstep, and there could be a rope around your ankle.
If there is, holler. Don't lift your feet. That's the worst thing to do, is to lift your feet. Just make sure you always know where you're at, where your hands are at, where everybody's at. Be safe. That's all there is to it. Nobody gets hurt this season.
Several years ago, Danny Soria learned this lesson the hard way.
It was probably about 3 o'clock in the morning. Must have been about 20, 25 foot seas, and blowing about 30, 35. And I was throwing the hook, you know. And then the other guy, just in all the commotion, he had thrown it in the block, and I didn't realize it was wrapped around me. Somehow the block got turned on, so that thing just snapped and just launched me 20 feet in the air. Started to panic a little bit at first. I gasped for air. I couldn't catch my breath, you know, and the waves were just breaking on my face. My rain gear started filling with water. I had sweats and started getting saturated, and I could just feel my boots filling with water and just being pulled down. And I thought to myself, God, what am I going to do now, you know? I look out of the corner of my eye, and I just see that first bag, and it just felt like God just answered the question. And almost like he was putting his hand out there just saying, you know, all you got to do is just swim and grab my hand. So I just gave it every last bit of energy I had. So once I made it to the big one, it was like having something to hold on to, you know. And that was pretty comforting, because I don't really think I would have made it if it wouldn't have been for that little orange bag. I saw the lights of the boat start turning around and coming back, so it was just a big sigh of relief. It was like, you know, everything's going to be all right. All I got to do is hold on to this bag. I remember seeing Tony on the deck there. There he was, just sitting there. He had that hook in his hand, and he just gave me that look. He just made eye contact with me. He had that, like, I'm not going to let you down. You know, I'm going to get you. I'm going to get you. To this day, you know, I owe both Rick and Tony, you know, pretty much my life. You know, at least they did come back and get it. So, you know, I owe them a lot.
Danny was lucky. He could have easily died in the freezing 30-degree water.
Good for human consumption.
In addition to lures, Lance has spent years trying to concoct an artificial time-release bait.
This is Lance's experimental pup. Will be 406. 406.
Canter hoods triggered.
First experimental.
Roger, this is the first experimental.
As the sun sets, the crew begins to launch the first string of pots.
We're going to throw all 250 pots out, varying from anywhere from 30 pots to 40 pots a string, and we'll keep setting until they're gone. So we have a clean deck, and then we'll turn around and start picking them up.
The pot launching will continue throughout the night. Tony assigns the greenhorn specific tasks. They get the idea, but executing will prove hard and sometimes scary.
Watch your feet, Joe.
go for that other hook.
Very physical and extremely dangerous. In any instant, a fisherman could get hit by a swinging pot or snap a finger handling one or fall on the slick deck. Along the continental shelf, the seafloor suddenly rises from 2 miles to 600 feet. Deep ocean waters swirl up, depositing a rich layer of nutrients on the shallow ledge. Here, on the cold edge of the abyss, the world's largest schools of crab gather to feast. They are attracted to the pots by oils released from the bait jugs filled with chopped herring.
You know, on the promenade deck, they have the no smoking.
Oh, that's right.
On that entire
deck. The main dining room, too.
Yeah.
I heard they have a ship, too. The whole ship is...
Yeah. What's the name of that ship again?
Paradise.
The Paradise.
But the whole thing is non-smoking.
The whole ship is non-smoking.
Really?
So when you board and you have anything, contraband, so to speak, you have to hand it into the crew. And at the end, they'll give it back, and that just keeps everybody honest.
But I think that's really great for those who just really can't stand the smoke.
Do you, Yahoo?
I'm the State Farm agent here in Montpelier. For a one-stop light town, we do get our share of accidents. When somebody has an accident,
it's unsettling enough.
The last thing they want to deal with is calling 1-800 and put in your 12-digit number. That's not very personal.
Over 16,000 State Farm agents.
Our rates for car insurance are very competitive.
It's no accident. They insure more cars than anyone else.
This is my town.
Hi, Jasmine.
Said it.
Ever get the feeling some people just stop trying? At Avis, service has no boundaries, which is why we're equipping our cars with OnStar.
OnStar, may I help you?
So help is never more than a button away. Avis, we try harder.
Tonight, the latest science, new discoveries, a lost world comes back to life. Land of the Mammoth. Tonight at 8 on the Discovery Channel.
After the grueling deck work, galley chores are almost a relief.
Days like this is not too fun.
24 hours of weather coming up.
Not only do you have to watch what you do, but you have to watch the weather.
When the signal one long horn means clear the deck no matter where you're at.
Well, for sure.
Your buzzer?
It's every man for himself.
That comes on, doesn't go off. That means you drop whatever you're doing, you get under shelter. I don't care what you're at or what you got a hold of, you just run. You get under the shelter.
With bad weather on the way, the greenhorns will hear the alarm much sooner than they could ever imagine. Since ages past, this verse has been a part of the seafarer's lore. Red sky at night, sailor's delight. Red sky at morning, sailors take warning.
Yeah, beautiful red sky, as you can see. High winds up in the atmosphere there with streaking clouds. Storm warnings are going to be coming into here this afternoon. We've got high atmosphere winds. Barometer's dropping. We're in for a ride today.
Storm warnings is a technical term weather forecasters use to predict ferocious conditions, winds of 55 to 65 miles per hour that create high, powerful waves. Despite these storm warnings, the crew keeps working. The size of the Fierce Allegiance provides some protection against the storm, but only up to a point. To retrieve the crab pots, the hook man tosses a heavy, four-pronged hook attached to 75 feet of line. This hook must catch one of the bowie lines tied to the pot. If it misses, the boat will have to circle back, losing valuable time. After sitting on the bottom for 20 hours, the first pot of the season is winched up. The numbers are excellent.
Oh yeah, 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 yeah. First pot looks pretty good. So, things are looking good. Keeps up this kind of average, everybody's gonna be smiling in about 52 hours.
But the storm is moving in. And soon, a smile will be the last thing you will find anywhere on the Fierce Allegiance.
Come on, you guys. We've got to use our heads, man. I'm reading so far behind. You got three guys on that side of the table knowing by the shit shoes. How effective is that? I'm not going to be out here for 12 hours a day.
The Opelio crab are dropped into one of six live holding tanks. Together, the tanks carry up to 300,000 pounds of crab. Fresh seawater is circulated to keep the crab alive until a Fierce Allegiance returns to port. The greenhorns aboard the Fierce Allegiance are quickly learning the craft of crab fishing. Sometimes, the hard way.
Hey, by the buoy. Hey, by the buoy. He threw it and I was running past and it pegged me in the face. You still got blood on your nose, weird.
Then what'd you do?
Nothing.
Kept running?
Kept running.
The hard work is starting to take its toll.
What's that on your wrist?
Oh, it's a brace. You wake up during the night with your arms all numb. Your hands will hurt. Just got to do just to get them moving.
And you wake up in the morning with a fist. Some people call it a claw. Because you can't open your hands until you start using them a little bit more and more.
The Coast Guard has received a report of a man overboard from the fishing vessel West Point. Keep a sharp lookout for signs of distress. If possible, and notify the nearest Coast Guard station.
Early the next morning, Rick picks up a call of a man overboard from the Coast Guard.
Yeah, there's a rescue helicopter, a Coast Guard helicopter flying around now looking for a man that got washed overboard this morning in heavy seas. And we have a cutter right now off our starboard side looking for the body.
The search for the man overboard goes on into the night.
And hopefully they'll find the body, but there's a good 99% chance they won't find the body.
It's just on the radio, somebody got washed overboard. They haven't found them, they're still searching.
He'll stay afloat as long as he can tread the water until he, you know, goes numb and then, you know, starts to sink and then he'll go down and stay down.
The body was never found. The crew now start to pull up some of the pots containing Lance's experiments. The pot with the disco lights comes up first. It's DOA, dead on arrival.
Yeah, that baby worked good, didn't it? Kind of thought it would leak.
Later that evening, the men haul in better news. The pot with Lance's time release bait.
I like it. I'm real pleased with the performance. There's a lot of the bait is still left, which means they can just leave it in the pot and keep using it. No sign of sand, please.
Sand fleas aren't actual fleas, but rather tiny aquatic creatures that can devour the bait from an entire jug before the crabs arrive. With the temperatures falling rapidly, the crew prepares for bad weather.
Working on deck is a very physical job. It can be very cold and wet. You get a 40 or 50 knot winds out of the north or northeast. The chill factor starts going down. We'll start making ice. Temperatures below zero. They're 18 hours on the deck, but they get paid well for it, and they work hard for it.
The Fierce Allegiance tanks, pumps, and powerful engines are monitored closely by the chief engineer.
Change out a valve on the aft wraparound ballast tank. Probably an obstruction in there. We'll take it apart, free the valve so you don't get any leak into the ballast tank.
Before fuel goes to the engine, it must be carefully filtered to prevent contamination by seawater. If the vessel were to lose power, it would quickly be at the mercy of the waves. And the sea can be a harsh mistress. As she was a few years ago, to the crab fishing vessel, the Alaskan Monarch, and Captain Morris Hansen.
The day of the incident, we had been trying to get into St. Paul to deliver our product. We had a load of crab aboard, and we'd been fishing for several days, dodging around the ice. There was about a 2 mile band of ice in front of the processor, but I didn't give us much thought because it was loose and we'd been in and out of the ice quite a few days.
Navigating through ice fields carries hidden dangers. An iceberg sheared off the Alaskan Monarch's rudder, leaving her unable to steer. Giant swells turned the boat broadside and tossed it slowly, inexorably, towards the shore. As it crept closer to the rocky coast, the Monarch sent out a mayday.
We're not grounded yet. This is the chief engineer. We have not grounded yet, but we are real close. Asking Monarch, Storrs Roger, get somebody out after your pilot house here. We're going to shoot your line here.
This is the engineer. Go ahead and stand by.
The Coast Guard cutter, Storrs, tried to fire a tow line to the stricken vessel. All attempts fail. The boat drifts towards certain doom.
Roger, helicopter be here in about 5 minutes.
It becomes the helicopter's job to lift the crew off the boat. At first, the rescue goes smoothly. The Coast Guard helicopter hoists one crew member after another off the bow of the boat. Safe and all possibility of saving the ship gone, the captain and chief engineer head for the bow.
Go, go.
job now gets much more difficult and dangerous. The basket has to get close enough for the men to grab it. But the waves keep pulling them away. The maneuver must be performed before the men lose consciousness or strength, before they freeze or get pulled under, or are crushed between boulders and car-sized blocks of ice.
Oh, no!
First, the chief engineer. Captain Hansen suffers severe chest injuries, but he will recover.
When I lost the boat, it was a great loss, especially watching it grind to its death. It's not easy to take.
In the next few hours, the fierce allegiance will face the full force of the worst storm to hit the Bering Sea in 18 years.
A pleasure to see you again, sir. Your usual seat?
He's here! He's here! He's here!
He's here? Come on, drop it.
Watch this, girl. Can I take care of the eucalyptus, sir?
I'm in. Stop this mess.
It's lovely to see you again, sir.
Once you've experienced Qantas business class, nothing else will do.
No. I saw her. She was shaved.
An Irish setter with hair like hers? Shameful.
Well, you didn't hear it from me. But I heard she had fleas.
Oh, my goodness.
Don't dogs use Advantage?
Since I was a pup his age.
I use it every month, and I've yet to see a flea.
It's never too early to be flea-free.
Ask your veterinarian for Advantage now. Don't give fleas a biting chance.
What's a flea?
Every time you post your resume on the web, you put your dreams, your hopes, your future on the line. Don't get lost in cyberspace. Come to thingamajob.com and connect with a career counselor who will match you with the right opportunity. thingamajob.com. Life 2.0 begins here.
You know, this is great.
Rediscover the lost art of conversation. Go RVing. Life's a trip. Visit an RV dealer or call for a free video.
Coming up next, quest for the giant squid. And tonight, a lost world comes back to life. Enter the land of the mammoth. Premiering tonight at 8 on the Discovery Channel.
Oh, come on. Sure.
No. She's doing it again.
I can't believe it.
Sophia.
Eh?
Who are you talking to?
Billy. I will come.
Billy. But he's in America.
I know.
Hey, Mom. Who is that?
My friend. She's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
With MSN Messenger service, you can send messages and even talk to your online buddies right from your homepage.
She's doing it again.
Mm-hmm. 20,000 years ago, his journey began. Born into a hostile world to fight. To be hunted. And finally, to die. 3,000 years later, the latest science, new discoveries, his lost world comes back to life. Enter the land of the mammoth. Tonight at 8 Eastern and Pacific on the Discovery Channel. Bigger than your imagination.
Hey, kid.
Fame is the goal of every warrior who steps into the ring. Fortune is his reward for destroying all challengers. In the end, what they crave most is power. You cannot imagine what they'll do to get it all until you order WCW Greed. Sunday, March 18th at 8 Eastern, live.
Catch it on GCI Pay-Per-View.
The action is in demand. Pay-Per-View for the demanding viewer.
When you've got something special to say, say it with a diamond from Carl's Jewelers and Gifts. A family-owned business, Carl's has been serving Alaska with quality diamonds for over 50 years. Carl's has a large selection of diamonds, solitaires, engagement rings, anniversary bands, earrings, and pendants, all at low prices. Carl's also does complete diamond jewelry repair and professionally certified appraisals. At Carl's, you'll find a large selection of guaranteed and certified diamonds. Carl's Jewelers and Gifts in the University Center.
Bitter Arctic storm has suddenly engulfed the fierce allegiance. Smaller, more vulnerable boats are heading home or seeking shelter in the Pribilof Islands, north of the fishing grounds. The storm has also grounded the Coast Guard helicopters. Because of the size of the boat, Rick Message and his crew can continue to work, but now they are completely on their own. If they get into an emergency, there will be no one nearby to respond. Deck boss becomes a bear in this weather.
What's going on here? You're freaking around over here.
In the storm, Tony doesn't allow the man to slack off. Under these conditions, a mistake could be fatal. Are tracking at 80 miles an hour, and the waves are cresting at 38 feet. Fury, and the storm is getting worse. Real fear creeps into the minds of the men.
Come back there, watch your starboard side there, money mate.
Rogue waves slap the deck.
It's just nasty out here.
Once waves begin to surge across the deck, even large boats no longer provide protection. If you are swept overboard, your life will hang between you, the water, the skill of your shipmates, and luck. Until the storm lets up, crab fishing in the Bering Sea will be pure hell.
Three more pots back there. Let's go up. Hey! Get here. Get over here. Get over here. Everybody's off deck. Everybody's gone.
Hello, nightfall, the storm has grown so violent that even the men of the Fierce Allegiance must abandon their work.
When you're done with that, bring that back, would you? So it's the last one on the boat. Yeah, we're stocking these things. Make people keep it for sentimental reasons.
Nothing sentimental about an injury.
During the break from work, the crew sits down for its first real meal in a week. For now, the sea rules the deck. By the next morning, the storm has let up just enough for the men to go back to work. It's a simple proposition. Time is money. Tony pushes the men to make up for lost time, but the crew seems to have lost its rhythm. The crew struggles against gusting winds and high seas, while productivity continues to fall.
72 pots is all we got in. Well, we worked hard at it, that's for sure. They battled steady 20, 25 foot seas.
These may be the most dangerous times of all. The storm surges erratically and fatigue muddles the mind. If you let your guard down for even a moment, the price may be your life. Try to imagine the terrible death that every crab fisherman dreads. You are working on deck. A rope gets looped around your leg, but you don't notice. The pot gets launched, and you are yanked overboard with it. Sear your mind. As pressure builds, your ears pop. The two quarts of air in your lungs are your only tie to life. The instinct not to breathe underwater is so strong that it overcomes the agony of running out of oxygen. Your mind blurs, but you resist the urge to inhale. Carbon dioxide is building in your blood. This eventually triggers chemical sensors in the brain. You are 400 feet underwater and sinking fast, but you gasp for air. Salt water bursts into your lungs and ends the transfer of oxygen to the blood. Your body jolts and writhes, trying to reject the rude intrusion. Its bottom at 600 feet. Your eardrums implode. Your pulmonary artery has constricted and is sending blood only to the lungs, where there's supposed to be air. But there's none left. Deprived of oxygen, you soon black out. Your heart labors and starts to beat erratically. After several minutes, it stops. Only the brain lives on. Its electrical activity gets weaker and weaker. And then, 15 minutes later, it ceases altogether. Like a hanging cod, you are now fair game for the creatures of the deep.
Colors you can only find in the country. Deep forest green, rich cranberry red. And these were the inspiration for the Country Colors collection by Ethan Allen. With our simple finance plan, it's a surprisingly affordable way to bring a fresh look to your home. Whether it's a farmhouse or a penthouse. The simple finance plan, only at Ethan Allen.
Thank you.
digitally record two shows at the same time. Only with Ultimate TV. Watch what you can do.
As if there weren't enough reasons to stay at La Quinta, here's 10 more. $10 cash when you check out. Look for this coupon in USA Today or at LaQuinta.com. And call La Quinta. You stay. We pay.
I am not an electrician. I am not a decorator. I am not a mover. I'm a homebuyer. And I could use some help.
Coldwell Banker has a time-saving service for home buyers and sellers. Coldwell Banker Concierge, now found on coldwellbanker.com, is designed to help you take care of the details of moving.
I'm not a landscaper, I'm not a painter, and I'm going to be okay.
coldwellbanker.com. When you need an address, try ours.
Coming up next, quest for the giant squid. And tonight, a lost world comes back to life. Enter the land of the mammoth. Premiering tonight at 8 on the Discovery Channel.
Olympic gold medalist and four-time WNBA champion Cynthia Cooper faces her biggest challenge. Teaching.
When I can motivate a kid to want to learn, that's when I feel like a champion. The tool I use is a basketball, but many teachers use cable in the classroom. With commercial-free educational programs, free study guides, and internet support, Cable in the Classroom helps teachers become champions.
Cable in the Classroom is a public service of Discovery Channel and your local cable company.
Now we're going to work on your slam dunk.
The latest science, new discoveries. A lost world comes back to life.
Less than 1% of that block has been looked at, and we're finding things about the plants, the microfauna, about the animal itself. We're getting a more complete picture than just if we brought the bones back. 99% of that block is still waiting to be opened.
Enter the land of the mammoth. Tonight at 8 Eastern and Pacific on the Discovery Channel. Continue the Discovery experience. Go to discovery.com.
The hookman's toss has failed. Tony makes a last-second effort to snag the buoy before the boat passes. Whenever they fail to hook the line, they lose valuable time circling back. To make matters worse, the storm has badly reduced the catch.
And it was only 99 in the last one, Rick. 99. Chief, you can't wait, man. Throw it, man. The sooner you throw it, the faster we'll get it in. If you miss, the guy's in the backup. I'll be on the backup. You can't control this boat weather like this, so you gotta just take as many shots as you possibly can. If you keep turning around, man, it's just gonna end up costing us a whole day of fishing.
After 11 hard, sleepless, brutal days, the men of the Fierce Allegiance have had enough. Holes are filled with crab and supplies are running low. It's time for the Fierce Allegiance to return to port.
Hey, grab the rest of the bait jugs out of the freezer. What? There's no more. Okay, use up all that bait. This is the bait man. Put it in the sacks. Put it in the sacks. It's getting ready.
Going back. All right.
Hey, Rick,
exhaustion has taken its toll, and the bone-weary crew catches up on lost sleep. As for Lance Nylander and his experiments, some worked, and some didn't. Once they dock in Dutch Harbor, the crew will have little time for R&R. The boat will stay in port only long enough to unload and restock with bait and supplies. The first catch of the Fierce Allegiance turns out to weigh 270,000 pounds. At 90 cents a pound, that means almost a quarter of $1 million. The live crabs go directly from the boat to a processing plant. There, they are sent through a hopper, then eviscerated into two sections. The gills, which are inedible cartilage, are ground off the crab cluster. Then the crab is sorted according to size, boiled in hot water, chilled in a series of cooling tanks, and frozen. The frozen processed crab is boxed and ready for shipment all over the world. Just 24 hours after docking, the fierce Allegiance heads back to sea, pushing for as many runs as it can in the 8-week season. By the end of the season, it will surpass the million-pound goal by 100,000 pounds and earn just shy of $1 million. And despite the worst weather in 18 years, the entire crew will make it through the season bruised, battered, but unbeaten. Even with all the modern technology, crab fishing still fits in the ancient mold of man against the sea. The crew will heal and share their stories with men from other boats. Stories of storm blasts, towering waves, and near-fatal spills. And the greenhorns will begin to amass the stories of their own lives at sea. All fishermen have tales to share for as long as they stay with the job, or as long as they survive. The Coast Guard will attest to the season's tragic toll. It will assist 26 vessels, radio medical advice 9 times, evacuate 16 crew members, and search for 2 men overboard whose bodies were never found. The season's greatest tragedy will strike in its last week. A boat called the Lin J will sink and take the lives of all 5 crew members. Overall, the fatalities will confirm once again why crab fishing in winter in the Bering Sea is considered the deadliest job in the world.